Whether you're grabbing a quick bite to eat or sitting down to enjoy a meal, food makes a difference in your day.
Describe what you're feeling when you don't get enough food.
Well, my stomach didn't get this way from not eating.
But when Franco LaDon does not eat,
I go rampant. I go all over the place.
He's not alone. We talked with several people about being hangry.
Being hangry is something that, you know, it feels like it should be a small thing, but when you're in the moment, it feels like the biggest thing ever.
The word that's commonly used has made its way into the Oxford Dictionary. Hangry is defined as angry or in a bad mood because you were hungry.
Being hangry, yeah, is the worst thing in the world. Especially when you're driving your car and you're hangry, you know, that'll cause an accident.
When my kids don't get their snack, they get very cranky and they get like agitated. So when I feed them, they're like happy again with their energy back moving, you know, being kids, just being normal.
I get hangry all the time. I mean, especially, you know, if I've had a long day at work, I haven't had anything to eat yet. You know, it kind of, my stomach's sending signals to my brain saying, hey, we're hungry. And well, small frustrations turn into bigger frustrations at that point.
Hangry may not be a medical term, but doctors say there's a medical reason why people feel irritable if they don't eat. Here's the breakdown. First, your stomach sends signals to your brain. That's the feeling of hunger.
So when you don't eat for a long time, the brain recognizes this because it's getting signals from your stomach and your intestines that say that you haven't eaten for some period of time. So you have a sensation that drives you to go eat something, find something and eat it.
David Romito is a clinical assistant professor in the Department of Medicine and the Division of Endocrinology at UPMC. He says your body wants the right amount of nutrients.
If you don't eat for long enough, you may actually go into a fasted state where your blood sugars do go down, but they're not low. They're just in a range where your body will make adrenaline and cortisol, two hormones that help keep your blood sugar from ever going low.
He says the hormones can affect your mood, behavior, and create stressful feelings.
That irritable response, that stress response from cortisol and adrenaline, or from other aspects of chemistry in the brain, maybe we don't yet understand, can affect how quickly we think and what drives the decisions we make and whether we're being even maybe emotionally intelligent with the people we work with.
Romito says eating shuts off the signal that you're hungry. The stomach tells your brain you have eaten, then the hormone levels that make you hangry go down.
And doctors say it's not just eating that improves your mood. The type of food you eat makes a big difference. The healthier the food, the better you feel.
Colleen Hereditario with the Healthy Food Center for Allegheny Health Network says carbohydrates keep blood sugar levels up and gives you energy. Proteins help muscle building and keep you active. And fruits and vegetables provide vitamins and minerals so your body can properly function. Without that combination, she says it could be a recipe for a bad mood and even worse, long-term health conditions.
This exacerbates issues such as diabetes. You know, you can't manage your blood sugars if you're not eating, you know, healthy, nutritious food sources.
Finding healthy food can be difficult for people who live in food deserts or are struggling to make ends meet. Erin Kelly at the Greater Pittsburgh Community Food Bank says more people need their help, especially because of the COVID-19 pandemic.
Beyond the kind of physical or physiological effects of being hungry or being food insecure, we're also seeing families experiencing extreme stress because they have to make really difficult choices between paying for their utilities and paying for food, or worse yet, paying for medications that they really need.
Kelly says the food bank is working hard to provide healthy meals and prevent anyone from going hungry or experiencing the emotional response of being hangry because of lack of food. Chandi Chapman, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.